Hello, I am Devan. Today I am going to present you the experiment number 3, vibration and rotation and spectrum of HCl. This is your experiment setup, what we will going to use. And in this experiment, first step is you have to measure the 5 gram of sodium chloride to a double neck bottle. You can see it, and this is sodium chloride 5 gram. And after that, you have to measure the 5 milliliter of sulfuric to a dispensing funnel. You can see it here. Now I am going to fix the double neck bottle and the dispensing funnel and the IR cell to the experimental setup. Before that, you can put some grease to the surface of this glass tube. After that, you can After that, I am going to fix the dispensing funnel. Make sure this valve should be closed. If it is not fixed well, you can also use some grease to this tube also. After fix these two, you have to clamp these two. Like this. Make sure this metal clamp is fixed well. This is the IR cell, and make sure do not touch these two sides. And now I am going to fix this IR cell to the experimental setup. Now I am going to fix the cold trap. Before that, you have to clean the O-ring. For that, you can use the ethanol and do not use the acetone and any other solvent. Then you can put this O-ring like this, and now we can clamp it. You can hold the trap like this and use the clamp. And you can fix the clamp like this. You can use this valve and make sure it is fixed well and do not fall. The next step is close the A, B, C, D and E valves. I can show you these valves in the setup. This is valve A, valve B, valve C, val t and val e. You can see these labels in your experimental handbook. Now I am going to close this, all the valves. You can hand tight it. The next step is turn on the exhaust valve and fume hood. If these two are already open, you no need to open again. I can show you the fume hood, how to turn on this. You can turn on the switch. For the exhaust valve, you can turn on this valve like this. The next step is turn on the pump. After that, you can sequentially turn on the valve A and valve E. First valve A. Make sure to do not exceed this line, and also we can turn on the valve E. When you turn on the valve E, you can see in the gauge the pressure is decreasing. Observe the pressure of the gauge. It should be below 600 millitorque. Next step, open the B valve. Make sure there is no leakages. When you open the valve, you can see the pressure is increase and again get back to the decrease. If there is a leakage, the pressure is not going back to the 600 or millitorque. You can see now the pressure is around 600 millitorque. If the pressure do not go decrease, you have to close again the B, C and D valves. After that you can check open one by one. For example, you can open the D valve and check the pressure again for the leakage. If there is a leakage, you can check this part. If it is not no problem here, you can close it again. Then you can reopen this valve and check here. Now I am going to open the B valve. Close the valve A and also valve E to prevent the gauge from the HCl gas. gas transfer. For that you have to turn on the valve of the dispensing funnel very slowly. Do not open this more fast. You have to add the sulfuric to the sodium chloride very slowly. Now the reaction happened and it's Cl gas formation occur. And do not add the all the amount of sulfuric to the double neck bottle, because if you do this, the air of the dispensing funnel can enter to the setup. Here now you can see the sodium chloride and sulfuric are reacting and make the HCl gas. This HCl gas may enter to the setup and collecting into the IR cell. After 5 minutes you can see the reaction is almost done and we have collected enough HCl for the IR cell. Then you can close the valve. Now I am going to use the cold tap to condense the remaining HCl in the setup. After you fix the cold trap, before that you may see some white smoke because the heat transfer from the distilled to the nitrogen, but now you see the no white smoke. The reason is the temperature is getting low and now we can move on to the next step. The next step is you have to close the valve D. And open valve A to collect the HCl to the cold trap. After that, open the valve E to measure the pressure. Okay, after 10 minutes we have collected the HCl into the cold trap. After that you have to close the valve C. Then you can remove the IR cell for the HTIR experiments. Make sure this D valve is also closed. After you take out the IR cell, you can bring this one to the FTIR machine to see the spectrum. After your experiment and after you take in the FTIR spectrum, you can keep this IR cell in the tube. and also make sure to open this valve to remove the HCl gas. Now I am going to venting the experimental setup. That means I am going to bring the pressure of this setup to the atmospheric pressure. For that we can open the valve C or exhaust valve, and after that we can turn off the pump. In here I use the exhaust valve to venting the setup. Then you can turn off the pump. After venting the setup, make sure you have to close this exhaust valve. Now I am going to remove the coil trap. For that you have to remove this coil trap with the Dulcimer bottle. First you can remove the clamp. And bring both of these to the exhaust cabin. Now I am going to remove the double neck flask and the dispensing funnel. You can keep these two in the exhaust cabinet.